Hello everyone, welcome to another webinar by Fineness Institute of Clinical Research. We have recently, a lot of suggestions have come for the top 15 interview question in pharmacovigilance. We have already shared one on clinical research and clinical data management. So, obviously, the first question is going to be pharmacovigilance, and we need to know the correct definition. So pharmacovigilance is the science and activity related to the detection, assessment, understanding and prevention of adverse effects or any other drug-related problems. Aims of pharmacovigilance is to improve patient care and safety in relationship to the use of medicines and all medicine and paramedical interventions, improve public health and safety in relationship to the use of medicine, contribute to the assessment of benefit, harm and effectiveness and risk of medicines, encouraging their safe and rational and more effective use. So the most important aim of pharmacovigilance is for the drug that is in the market to be safe and effective. Promote understanding, educate and clinical training in pharmacovigilance and effective communication to the public. Many healthcare providers are not aware of what is pharmacovigilance and how to report ADRs in their specific country, which obviously will come through training. And whatever the result or the side effects of the medicines are, that is also need to be communicated into the public. Decrease the economic burden of adverse drug reactions on the healthcare system. So any adverse drug reaction can have a lot of repercussion in terms of hospitalization and death that are easily preventable if these ADRs were reported on time. So pharmacovigilance cycle is recognize and manage, prevent, report, collect, analyze, study, then we have to take an action on it and communicate and treat the subject. Adverse event, any untoward medical occurrence that may be present during the treatment with a pharmaceutical product. It can be a drug. Pardon me. It can be any untoward medical occurrence that may be present during treatment with a pharmaceutical product, but which does not necessarily have a causal relationship with the treatment. And adverse events can therefore be any unfavorable and unintended signs, including an abnormal laboratory finding, symptom, disease temporarily associated with the use of medicinal product, whether or not related to an investigational product. So an adverse event may or may not be related to the adverse events. It doesn't have a causal relationship. May or may not have a causal relationship. Adverse drug reaction, as the name suggests, it is caused by the drug. A nauseous response, which is nauseous, unintended, which occurs at dose normally used in human for the prophylaxis, diagnosis or therapy of a disease or for that modification of a physiological function, a response to a medicinal product which is nauseous and unintended. Frequencies of ADRs, in a given estimate of the frequency of ADRs, there are many, more than 10%, very common. Common is it's greater than 1% and less than 10%. Uncommon is greater than 0.1 and less than 1%. Rare is greater than 0.01 and less than 0.1. And very rare are less than 0.1%. Now there's another term, that is serious adverse events. That means it can lead to death, life-threatening, hospitalization, persistent disability or incapacity, congenital abnormality, or any other medical event deemed significant by the investigator. So it can be unexpected, and cannot be related to the interventional or the medical product that is being given. Another term that is very important is National Pharmacovigilance Centers. What are they? They are organizations recognized by government to represent their country in the WHO program. A single government recognized center with a country with the clinical and scientific expertise to collect, analyze, and give advice on all information related to drug safety. Now, when we are talking about India, we'll be discussing what is the Pharmacovigilance Program of India, that is PVPI. It was launched with the broad objective to safeguard the health of the people of India. Adverse drug reactions are reported from all over the country to the National Coordinating Center, PVPI, which also works in collaboration with the Global ADR Monitoring Center, that is WHO, UMC Sweden, to contribute to the global ADR database. National Coordinating Center, PVPI, monitor the ADRs among Indian population and help Regulatory Authority of India, CDSCO, as well as India Pharmacopoeia Commission in taking decision for the safe use of medicines. So if any ADRs are come across and are reported, and what actions will be taken, it will be the responsibility of Pharmacovigilance Program of India. Now, when we talk about Europe, they have a Eudra Vigilance. European Union Drug Regulatory Authority Pharmacovigilance is the European data processing network and management system for reporting and evaluating of suspected adverse drugs to medicines which have been authorized or being used in a clinical trial in the European economic. The European Medicinal Agencies operate on the system of the European Union Medicine Regulatory Network. Causality Assessment. So the assessment of the likelihood that the medicines was the causative agent of an observed drug reaction, adverse drug reaction. Causality assessment is usually made as per the established algorithm. If I have an adverse drug adverse event, a reaction, maybe a rash is there, we need to know it was caused by the drug or it was unrelated to the drug. Maybe it has other factors, so which were contributing for the rash to occur. So there are different scales. One of them is Naranjo algorithm. These are the questions that will be asked. And on that basis, you have to give points. And if it's greater than 9, it's definite. And it's 5 to 8, it's probable. And it's 1 to 4, it's possible. And 0 means it's doubtful. It is not related to the drug. Another scale that is commonly used is the WHO causality categories. It is divided into certain, probable, likely, possible, unlikely, conditional, unclassified, unaccessible, or unclassifiable. So these are the terms, and these are the different assessment criteria. Another term that is commonly used in pharmacovigilance is re-challenge and re-challenge. These means the withdrawal of a drug from a patient, the point at which the continuity, reduction, or disappearance of adverse events may be observed. So as I was talking about the rash, and suppose we stop the medicine, stop that specific drug we are taking, and we see if the rash disappears or it's aggravated or it is the same. And that is called de-challenge, when we are stopping the medicine. Re-challenge is there, the point at which the drug is again given to the patient after its previous withdrawal, also see these challenges. So re-challenge is when we stop a drug, that is de-challenge. But after stopping the drug, we again reintroduce the drug and see if the drug is causing that same rash in me again and again or not. signal is the most important definition. It is the reported information of a possible causal relationship between an adverse event and a drug, the relationship being unknown or incompletely documented previously. Usually more than a single report is required to generate a signal. Depending on the seriousness of the event and the quality of the information, the publication of a signal usually implies the need for some kind of a review of action. So signal, as the name suggests, so we get reports on adverse drug reactions, and we have to see the possible causal relationship with the drug and the reaction. We have to see that is a signal. And for a signal, we need more than one report. And see if we get, supposedly, if we get multiple reports on a certain drug and an adverse event, adverse drug reaction. So it increases the chances that this specific adverse drug reaction or the event is there, or the event is being caused by that specific drug. And that can be informed to the regulatory body as well as the people of India, so that to prevent any further fatal outcomes if of that specific drug, and so that the drug can be modified or withdrawn. So signals have a whole life cycle. Signal detection happens, then validation, signal analysis and prioritization, signal assessment, recommendations for action, and then the exchange of information takes place. Summary of product characteristics, a regulatory document attached to the marketing authorization, which form the basis of the product information made available to the prescriber and the patients. Methods, there are different methods, and we have a video on it. I'll definitely add that link in the end of the video. So there are passive surveillance, active, cohort, and targeted. There are many methods. Just listed the four. Now, individual case safety reports processing. So the ADR occurring in a patient are reported in the form of an individual case safety report. The form looks like this. Individual case safety report of an individual patient that provides safety-related information about the adverse drug reaction experienced by the patient. It has the main four minimum criteria are: it has to have an identifiable reporter who reported, identifiable patient, suspected adverse drug reaction, what is the reaction they occurred, and the medicinal product they think that is causing the adverse drug reaction. Another term is the medical coding. Medical coding is a classification of multiple several dermatism term using validated medication-based dictionary supplied by a customer, or under the license by a relevant licensing body. It is performed to facilitate the summarization analysis of certain sets of data, example, adverse event, medical history, concomitant medication, to provide control and consistency. A variety of medical coding dictionaries may be used to process, analyze, and report collected data. Another term is SA reconciliation. So the SA reconciliation, the SA reports are collected on two soft databases, clinical and master drug safety database. So what is SA reconciliation? Is we want the SA reports to be the same in both these databases. So clinical data management database is maintained by the clinical data management, and master drug safety database is maintained by the sponsor. So reconciliation is performed to ensure that event recorded in SE database and those residing in the clinical data are consistent. The main SEs and safety of the subject is very much paramount, and pharmacovigilance is all about that. So we have to take in extra efforts to see the SE data is being recorded properly and reported on time. So this is the SE reconciliation process. We have to compare data, review discrepancies, resolve discrepancy, and update the database. These are the 15 questions in pharmacovigilance interview. We'll definitely add more, but for any diploma courses or webinar-related queries. We offer corporate training as well. You can visit on fineness.com or send us an email on admin@fineness.com. Please do like us on Facebook and subscribe to our YouTube channel. It will help us in bringing better content in the near future. Thank you for listening.